So good afternoon, everyone. Once again, a very warm welcome to today's webinar on ensuring compliance throughout automotive design process. I am Archana, senior marketing executive at EDS Technologies, would be hosting today's webinar. Before we start our webinar, I would like to give you a quick and a brief introduction about EDS Technologies and the presenter of the day. So EDS Technologies Private Limited, shortly called as EDST, is the largest engineering enterprise solutions provider in India. With over two decades of experience in various industries, we enable companies in aerospace, automotive and supply chains, industrial machinery, high-tech and electronics, railways infrastructure, engineering service providers, defense and research verticals to achieve their business goals. EDS is established in 1995 and is headquartered in Bengaluru, Karnataka. The company operates with its direct presence in India, in Chennai, Coimbatore, Gurgaon, Hyderabad, Pune, Mumbai, Kolkata, Noida, Ahmedabad, Chandigarh, Mohali and Nagpur. It has the largest customer base in Indian PLM market and visual simulation market business and has successfully partnered with more than 1500 customers in various industry verticals. Today, we have our speaker for the webinar, Mr. Naresh Kataria from EDS Technologies, who is 10 years experience in automotive segments and is specialized at ergonomics and product engineering. He will be taking us through the webinar today. Please post your queries if you have any in the middle of the webinar in the chat box, if you have one. And I would be asking them at the end of the session for you, and Mr. Naresh Kataria would be answering them in detail at the end of the session. If you have any technical difficulties, please raise your hand or leave a message in the chat box. We will try to rectify it and come back sooner to you. Thank you, and over to Mr. Naresh.
Very good afternoon to all of you. Hi, I'm Naresh. I'm taking care for the ergonomics products as well as ramps and the titanium transport products, CAVA. Today, we will be discussing about the use of CAVA in legal compliance for automotive design. And we will discuss about in detail about the technical capabilities of CAVA in the automotive industries. And the rest, we will discuss about the questioning and answering. So CAVA, legal compliance is automotive design from starting to end. So CAVA ensures the legality of the vehicle architecture, international rules, norms and standards during the entire design process. CAVA is nothing but CAVA automotive extensions vehicle architecture. It resulted how it developed. It is resulted from a joint product by Technical Transport Company as well as the all the German automotive car manufacturers. With the international rules, norms and standards are provided during the entire design process, from the concept phase to the homologation department. So CAVA is feature-based and associative technology integrated with CATIA V5 and with 3D experience. So CAVA makes standards and guidelines relevant for the vehicle concept available as V5 features. CAVA is set of products like complete vehicle architecture, CAVA Vision in terms of the mirror analysis, the general mirror, direct view 3D, direct view, all these analysis we can perform. The CAVA safety talks about the safety regulations, then CAVA Manikin, CAVA Wiper, with the wiper we check whether the field of view is completely done by the CAVA mirror also, and the CAVA tools for generation of the reports. CAVA functionality like positioning of certain parts with respect to the vehicle position or specific reference element, like where is the required position, assessment of current position, including calculation of clashes and measurement. As well as if we talk about current position, if we are checking for the standard, whatever the design the automotive manufacturers are making, they have to pass through the compliance. So it is fulfilling the compliance the CAVA helps to do in the virtual design process. Visibility of specific parts according to given viewpoint from standards. Also the functionality, we talk about direct and indirect vision of the driver, as well as for passenger, check for sharp edges to small curvature radius, and as well as the wiper calculation. So doctor, from conception to SOP, like start with the car draft phase, and then comes to the car conceptualizations, then start with the component development, then we will final done. It goes to the homologation department, who certified that the design is okay. So CAVA helps from the starting observation of rule regulation during the entire design process. If we talk about mutual dependency of car parameter, there are several parameters on which CAVA, with the help of that, the CAVA helps to take with the help of those parameters to fulfill those standards regulations. So it evaluates the standard conformity of the current design state, quick associative reaction on modification of car parameters, and component geometry are required. As well as during car conception, a lot of iteration take place to find the optimal vehicle concept. As you know, this is the iterative process to make the car. We have to take care a lot of parameters. So CAVA helps with all those parameters to make your design faster, to certify it for the homologation department. So you can, with the help of CAVA, you can virtually simulate and do the with the standard, with the international standards, you can fulfill your design requirement. During component development, the geometry might be modified. As far as the geometry can be modified with your requirement. If we talk about the standards, CAVA has a lot of international and national standards and regulation. That is SAE, Federal Motor Vehicle Security Standards, ECE, ECG, MLIT, Japanese standards, ADR, Australian standards. Like for different functionality in the car, we have different example like rear view mirror, we use FMVSS, 111 EWG 71127 standards. So here is a list of few standards which I'm talking about: the seatbelt standards, bumper standards for the safety purpose, the Manikin ellipse point, SAE templates, field of view, head impact, Japanese close range visibility, it's called MLIT standards. The standards are fully configurable, XML based. Supports your organization on a standard, so you can customize your own standard and use CAVA while importing those standards and check for according to your organization your own standards. Some example, I have one car geometry. What the functionality we can check with the road clearance, it's called the ground clearance, SAE templates, rear view mirror standards, close range visibility standard, what is able to visualize, the field of view for the wiper calculations, for the Manikin visualization, the wiper, this is the wiper zone, the pedestrian protection. So these are the functionalities, the standards we can do very much easily in the CAVA and certified, and that report, the generated report, can be used for the homologation department. Leveraging car CATIA V5, as CAVA is integrated completely into CATIA V5, the new workbench CAVA vehicle architecture is called the overall vehicle architecture. Access to all CATIA V5 parameter for faster update after modifications. As this is the workbench as an add-on module for CATIA V5, you will be access of all the CATIA functionality. You can switch easily between the part design, assembly design, as well as in CAVA workbench and do the modification. So it is a faster way of doing the simulation to fulfilling the standards. The applicable standard with all selected values and options will stay in the feature tree all over the car design phase. So as CATIA have the functionality of a specification tree, so whatever the function you are using with the help of CAVA, you can easily access and visualize that functionality in the specification tree. The applicable standards are integrated as associative feature in the car feature tree and will be updated automatically. So now we are talking about the CAVA architecture. It's aggregated into different workbenches like CAVA OVA, the CAVA overall vehicle architecture in CAVA Vision, CAVA Manikin, CAVA Safety, and CAVA Wiper. The base for all these workbenches, CAVA base data. Here it includes the general vehicle parameter like width of the car, breadth of the car, like height, length of the car, all these parameters, the SRP point, all these function we have to put in CAVA base data. We have huge customer reference who are working on CAVA, the car OEMs like Audi, BMW, Bentley, Ford, Citroen, Honda, Lada, Seat. So many customers globally, they are using CAVA, are benefited by the CAVA tool. And also the suppliers who are supporting to the OEMs. Few names like we talk about EDAC, Gentex, NHK Springs, Ambitec, Magna Exterior. So in short, I will just give about the summary about the CAVA, why assures compliance of car design to national and international standards and norm regarding vehicle architecture. Make these standards and norm available as V5 features. Check geometry for compliance and support designers. If there is any modification like this is not fulfilling the standards, the CAVA, with the help of CAVA, that report can be given to the designers. They can see what the modification need to be done to fulfill the standards. Is a set of products. Now, CAVA technical overview. Like if we earlier in previous slide, we talk about the base data. The base data is the base for using the CAVA functionality. Defining all CAVA relevant vehicle parameters in one features. There is one window defining all relevant loading conditions used as common input for CAVA feature. Talk about the overall data, like vehicle center, where is the wheel center point according to the red front, the rim offset, the radius, all this functionality, all these parameters we have to put in this, the seat position, where is the SRP point, width of the vehicle, length of the vehicle, all these parameters we need to put for the base data. So base data will be the base for all coming functionality. Now the CAVA reports can be generated in HTML format, XLS, CAD drawing, etc. Documentation of the process for legal compliancy. Directly the CAVA can be give the reports for your car standards and regulations. So now we'll discuss in detail about the CAVA overall vehicle architecture. If we talk about the functionality about the vehicle architecture, the base is CAVA. Base data as well as the ground clearance, slope angle, many functionalities in overall vehicle architecture module is there. Like how to approach departure angle, ramp angle, ground clearance, curb stone clearance, combination of clearance lines in one single features, allows international measurement with geometry. So what should be the bumper height? It is following the standards for different countries. The standards we can check where we are supplying for our car. Create 3D pendulum shape according to road levels, mid rotated and shifted pendulums, position according to geometry. Additional transition provides the bumper to locate proper contact points, as well as the crash barriers. This is standard art CR 2004 and 2006 barriers. Position according to geometry, extendable by all 3D parts and with the help of configurations like seating belt, anchor points, where according to the SRP, the CAVA tells where should be the anchorage point, the upper inboard anchorage, the lower inboard anchorage, lower outboard anchorage, the fixation to car body, all these things the CAVA can tell you. The child restraint systems, like top tether positioning area and free space. The lamp position, where your putting the headlights, in which region it should fall. The CAVA tells with the standards, the light is in fulfilling the particular country standards or not. With the help of lap position, we can check that. It also support for different lamps types like low light, high beam, low beam, with fog lights, current, check current lamp geometry is okay or not okay. Also in terms of visibility, it tells how much area is visible with this focus of light, the number plate height, where it should be fixed, the number plate, whether where we have to give the slot for number plate, like wheel covering area, how much area it should be covered for the wheel, support of different algorithm, European, Japanese, Australian, different fields for rear wheel. Now talk about the CAVA Manikin. In Manikin, we have 2D Manikin templates. It's called the SAE Manikin templates with different percentile, also different percentage size. The positioning is based on the SRP point. SRP we provide into the base data. So you just have to import here the CAVA Manikin directly according to the base data. It will sit accordingly. And with the eye ellipse point, with the eye points, it will adjust the position, the correct position, and tell us with these it is fulfilling the standards or not. Like the clash with the steering wheel, is the Manikin lag is clashing or not. So all these space allocation according to the standards or not. So that we can check with the CAVA Manikin. Also selected geometry for floor or pedal, angle parameters from user input based data features, as well as positioning for rear passengers in accordance with SAE, like foot on floor, move forward till geometry clash, or 130 degree angle, back angle, additional positioning with different postures like floor, pedal, H30 posture model, the angles, hip with the posture 15. These are the name and nomenclature in the CAVA, which is already available, different posture. So according to that, it will adjust the posture accordingly. In CAVA Manikin, we talk about also the head position contour, like in accordance with SAE standards, as well as 2002 standards, calculate head clearance in vertical and diagonal directions. Also, it calculates the eye points, eye ellipse, in accordance with European standard for point, in accordance with SAE standard for ellipse. The SRP location curves, in accordance with SAE standard, where the short Manikin can sit, where the 95th percentile or taller Manikin will sit, and the medium Manikin. So different SRP location curves you will find out as standards. CAVA Vision, the general requirement. Now we have moved to more module, the CAVA Vision. Till now we had seen the CAVA overall vehicle architecture functionality, as well as the CAVA Manikin functionality. Now we talk about the CAVA Vision. The view of the driver has a significant influence for vehicle concept and in ergonomics. So we talk about the standard as well as ergonomics. Both are different factors and work together. So ergonomics increase the comfort of the driver, and the standards are fulfilling those criteria to pass your vehicle with the authority. Both functionality have their role. So in terms of, if we talk about the CAVA positioning of geometry, like A pillar, B pillar, front view, mirror positioning, dashboard positioning, so Manikin can easily visualize the things outside of the vehicle. Vision standard requires specific eye positions. How we check, generally the government authority checks the eye position, some length and height. The CAVA fulfill those standards automatically. Here are defined the standards, so CAVA tells whether these are okay or not okay. So CAVA Vision feature internally uses proper eye position, CAVA to use and error free. CAVA supports eye point as well as eye ellipse. The next is feature will automatically use the required row table. Row level panels are provided by base data features. All the parameters are defined in base data. We talk about the vision field of view on the windshield. So here you are seeing a red color and a green color. This is called A field and B field. Manikin is looking outside the car passing through the windshield. So here the red area here is focusing more. If we are doing the calculation of wiper, that area should be covered with the help of wiper. So with the different standard, we check with this field, the wiper calculation, this is okay or not okay. You know, what modification we have to do required, whether we have to increase the size of blade or decrease the size of blade. So all these iteration process we do to fulfilling the standard as well as ergonomics. Reference point on windshield and view limiting planes. Like if we talk about the suppliers, might be OEM will not share the data with the windshield. So, but they will get some reference, and this is your field of view. According to that, you have to define your wiper. The wiper manufacturer takes care according to that. So also A-pillar obstruction according to European standards, what should be the size of the A-pillar, how much area it can obstruct while Manikin is sitting and driving. So with the different standards, CAVA can easily check in the virtual platform and tells this is fulfilling your standards or not fulfilling. Optical properties of windshield like double image and distortion, different visualization options, calculation based on curvature, ray tracing, interactive or dynamic calculations. Like 3D direct view, what you are able to visualize from the outside with the help outside of the mirrors, outside of the windshield. So all these area which you are able to visualize is called the 3D direct view, visualization of obstructed areas in 3D. Obstruction of front view by pillars, engine hood, etc. View on dashboard covering due to steering wheel. So it displays directly. So how much area with the different standards, how much area we have to be visualized, that can be checked with the help of CAVA. Like calculation is currently not defined by the official standard, but generally is of high priority for organization internal requirements. Also, we talk about the close range visibility. The standards are Japanese MLIT standards, L shape in front and on passenger side, frontal view 2 meter in front of car with extension to left or right both sides. Like detection of blind areas is okay or violated depending on position to rear wheel, usage of mirror and camera, extended eye points, including possible movements, also contact to vehicle and different visualization options. So CAVA provides a fast and easy calculation of these standards. Now, rear view mirror in CAVA. So rear view mirror, let's talk about the visibility to the Manikin from the rear view mirror. So how much area they are losing, what is the blind spot. So all these calculations can be done by the rear view mirror. So adjustment of the mirror you're designing, the positioning is fulfilling the standards or not, can be checked with the help of CAVA mirror. So generally we are using a spherical mirror, can be extended also the other mirrors, the dynamic adjustment of mirror glass as well as calculates obstructed areas. Or obstructed areas, like we talk about obstruction through car geometry, definition, back curves and surface. Also we can check what do I see in mirror, where will I see another car or pedestrian, etc. So it's certified for European standards. So this is a, you can say the case study, the experimental setup and the CAVA, the result given by the CAVA. So rear view mirror already certified by technical authorities, further certifications. Talk about the complete vision outside the car. It's called the plane view GIKI. Create intersection plane according to GIKI through eye point. With the eye point, which area is visible, where the shadow is coming, which where we are not able to visualize properly. That area, this can be checked by the CAVA functionality. You can also do the screenshots as well as for that. Now the next module is the CAVA safety. Here we talk about the pedestrian protection, like calculation of required areas on engine road, whether your bumper is fulfilling the pedestrian protection or not, is the design is under the norms, under the standards or not. So CAVA tells, CAVA gives all these answers in the virtual platform. Calculation of reference curves on bumper and fender, pedestrian protection offset calculation including measurements is also possible. Also in have CAVA safety, we talk about the head impact. While driving, you have to see the area for the head, how much area is there from between the headliner and the top vertex of the head, and the space available. So head impact will do the calculation for all of those according to the standard FMVU SS201. Among others, the A pillar points, upper roof, B pillar points, etc. Plus, another one more functionality in CAVA safety is safety radius. It checks for the minimal curvature radius of the exterior design according to regulation ECE R26 or 74 or many more standard 483WG. Could be used already for the interior design, but in current implementation without specific pendulum movement. It talks about calculation of floor line and the upper limit. It's also talk about calculation of a specific requirement for the bumper as well as whether the geometry are reachable by the spare or not. Calculation of the curvature radius, interactive dynamic calculation by my sponsor. It's also talk about the specific handling for grill lamps. So multiple functionality in the CAVA safety with the safety radius are also there. Depending on the OEM, on which part or supplier they are working, they are more interested. So in all the functionality in CAVA, in all the modules, they choose according to their requirement. Also the minimum radius we can calculation according to ECR 21. It is similar as safety radius for interior design. Now the important thing about the, we can say the CAVA mirror we discussed, with the CAVA vision we can check field of view from the driver position, and that where should be your ideal position to accommodate the wiper. So whether wiper is fulfilling a standard and covering the A field and B field completely, and what the permits is decided by the standards can be fulfilled. So in the wiper, we do the calculation of wipe area on the windshield intended for wiper conception, easy modification of wiper parameters, together with field of view check of standard requirement covering of A, B, and C fields. Also, it calculates and visualizes different resulting parameters to improve the wiper, like curvature of blade on the windshield, normal deviation, windshield, floating axis, all those things. It also creates blade curve as V5 geometry for referencing. So CAVA Wiper is also a separate module which can use with the help of field of view. Thank you for this webinar. I will just brief about the demo videos where you can glimpse of the software easily. just have two videos, one for minimum CAVA overview functionality as well as the CAVA Vision, dedicated the vision. Very small video. So let's talk about how CAVA is integrated in CATIA. We can launch CAVA. Like, talk about the CAVA base data. CAVA wheel covering. Here we see there is a specification tree in the CATIA itself, and the workbench you can directly import into CATIA. These are the functionality for CAVA over this CAVA base data, CAVA slope angle, CAVA wheel covering, also this for seat belt, CAVA seating belt, CAVA mirror, CAVA field of view, A pillar covering, vision points, vision cone, vision planes, direct view 3D, visibility. Now we talk about the mannequin, CAVA head position contour, CAVA SRP points, head impact, and wiper. So in this, now we are accessing the CAVA workbench. Already the predefined data is there. We are accessing that data, the CAVA base data. So also the CAVA mirror, the CAVA vision. So here these you are seeing the output of the mirror CAVA vision, CAVA field of view. Here this is my field of view in the windshield. In yellow color you are seeing the A field, in blue color that is the B field. Also the pedestrian protection, the safety module. See the bumper pedestrian protection on this. Here now we are accessing the OVA toolbar, overall vehicle architecture toolbar. Now see one functionality, CAVA underfloor. Here this is the window for the CAVA underfloor complete. So first we have to select the base data. The base data where we put the all the parameters and the standards we are using, company on standards. I want to see this, looking for, interested to see the surface. So I click on the show surface. Let's see. This is the surface for underfloor covering. Now further the associative feature. This is the work window for the CAVA base data, where if you see here, where the overall data, the vehicle description, then you can give the name, the vehicle length, vehicle width, the overhang front and back, then let's go to parameters for the wheel, for also for the seat. Here the vehicle for automatic point, also the SRP point, seat reference point. You can put the coordinates for the seat reference point. Do okay. Now we access the CAVA mirror. Now we'll see, this is the overview about the CAVA functionality. I will show in detail the CAVA vision. Now this is talk about how to access CAVA vehicle architecture. Now we access the vision toolbar. is calculating the field of view. So we selected the base data as well as the screen, the windshield is selected. Here now we'll select the standard. So standard for A field and B field is selected. And we'll create the faces. Click on that. So according to the base data which you fill initially, we are able to find out the field of view. Now A pillar covering, select the base data, select the standard, create intersection geometry, so which is your left pillar, selected the pillar geometry. Go for right pillar and the right, and we'll select the right pillar geometry. Just okay. See the A pillar covering. So software. Now the CAVA mirror, base data, standard R46 or according which standard you want to check. Select the EG wall. Radius for spherical. Here it will the placement, the rotation point, the mirror position, the driver side as well as for passenger side, the reference point. The reference point is the center point, the, or we can say the rotation point. Select rotation point passenger and the contour. It is required for CAVA to do the check for the mirror, the contour is required. So we check the mirror contour passenger as well as the rotation angle defined. So now once we give this parameters and click on apply, it gives the rays of the mirror where we are able to see what area we are able to visualize. Now we will go for visualization. Different options are available on mirror surface, on IF plane, indirect, direct, and select which elements are obstructing. Click on add. See, in this area, you see, we're losing this area with these elements. So the next functionality, the close range visibility view. In this, the definitions, the that will remain same, as we have to select the base data, then we have to select the standards and the car geometry or mirror housing. I select the car geometry first. Here, click on offset geometry. And offset geometry, we are selecting the windows where we can see. Click on OK. So it gives the range for close range visibility. And access to the blind areas. We select the mirror which we created earlier. Now apply. With the help of mirror, we are able to see this one. The blind area can be covered with the help of mirror. For the outside here, down to this bumper, we are not able to see because we cannot keep a mirror with the help of where we can visualize. Also, the access to the direct view 3D. So we are selecting the outside geometry for direct view 3D. We selected the windshield and the outside windows for visualization purpose. And we can give the contour colors also. So that gives a direct view 3D where he is able to visualize or where he is not able to directly visualize which parts the car are losing. Thanks for this overview session. These are the very brief session on the CAVA, which I try to give some information of the CAVA functionality. We can discuss in detail if you are interested in any module of this CAVA functionality to understand in detail. For detailed demonstration, we can discuss on. Do you have any question regarding that?
Thank you, Mr. Naresh. So I guess we have few questions. Please post them on the chat boxes. I would be reading them out for you. I have seen few hands raised up. So Mr. Naresh, Gauri Shankar Ganesh sir is asking, what is the purpose of curvature tool?
Where can you write me? Radius curvature you are talking about?
Yes.
See, it checks about the safety radius for minimal curvature radius of the exterior design where mannequin can easily access in terms of safety. So it gives as a sphere box where it all those things come into the safety radius. That's why we give the as a use as a spare box and gives as a curvature.
Okay, Mr. Manikandan Shekhar has one question. He's asking, safety radius means the reachability zone of mannequins?
Yes.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, so we have one more question from Mr. Manova. ECE regulations, FMVSS and SAE are referred.
Yes.
Does CAVA check for AIS standards too?
AI, the Australian standard you are talking about? I need to check AI standards.
Mr. Manova, may I please know if it's referring to, no, it is Indian standards.
Yeah, you can import, as I told you, it is configurable, XML configurable. You can import the ARI standard inside the CAVA and work accordingly.
Okay. Mr. Manova, I hope it has answered your question. If you have any other queries, we are welcome to post it. So Mr. Sunny Silvera has one question. Do we have environment like traffic scenario for vision, rear view mirror?
The traffic scenario, the thing is that traffic scenario we are not considering. I think so. I did not check. I can check the traffic scenario and I can get back to you.
Do we have traffic light, road, etc.?
No. As of now, we don't have these kind of traffic scenery. But I had seen in some ergonomic software in this traffic scenery and do the visualization. But that is for not for a standard, that is for ergonomics point of view. And the software name is Ramses Cognitive.
Okay. Mr. Sanya, I think it has answered your query. If you have any other queries, you are please welcome to post them. Yeah, thank you. Any other questions, please post them on the chat box. We are here and more than happy to answer them. Okay, so I hope Mr. Naresh has answered. Okay, we have one last question. Mr. Manikandan Shekhar has asked one question. Are we doing further sessions on CAVA in brief with respect to standards?
Are we doing?
I think I can answer this question. Yes, sir, we definitely do. We don't stop it here. Based on your interest, we can even meet you
personally
at your place for any technical demo or a technical talk personally to give you any brief, anything additional information which is according to your requirement or according to your interest as such. Definitely we are not stopping at here. We will be continuing the sessions. So for the same reason, in the last slide I have mentioned, if you follow our social media channels, you will definitely get to know time to time what are the updates from our side, webinars, seminars, conferences, workshops. We do carry them very regularly. Thank you. There is one question from Mr. Manova. Can CAVA check the EMC compliance of a vehicle?
EMC. Yes, I feel.
It's an S.
It's
an S. So, I can even give you Mr. Naresh email ID also. It's just naresh.dlr@edstechnologies.com. If you have any other queries which you feel like not answered completely, or it can be having a deep discussion later regarding technicality, please feel free to reach us out at anybody's email ID, either mine or Naresh or the general email ID which I have mentioned. We would be answering every mail.
So according to that, we can also organize the detailed demonstration on the particular functionality according to your requirement. We can come at your premises and can deliver the same.
Okay. So think we have answered all the questions, and so thank you so much everyone for participating in the webinar. It's been a pleasure to meet you all here. Thank you so much again for making time. For sure we'll be coming up with more technical sessions, more webinars on your interested topics. Do keep in touch in social media channels so that you'll get to know our updates time to time basis. Thank you very much.